This is Indianapolis coach Reg Wayne, and you're listening to the For the Culture podcast.
With the 109th overall pick in the fourth round of the 2019 draft, the Indianapolis Colts select Kari Willis, strong safety, Michigan State. This is a 5'11", 213-pound strong safety that the Colts took 109th overall. They traded up from 123 to 109, so they swapped the 123 for the 109, and they gave up the 129th overall pick in addition to swapping. So they basically gave up two fourth-round picks to move up in the fourth round and get Kari Willis at 109.
Yeah, the more I watch this kid, the more I like the move, because he's exactly the kind of guy that Ballard likes. To start with, he's a great leader, high-character guy, hard worker, was a team captain at Michigan State. He was a productive player and very consistent, and that's what you look for in a player. And as far as what he does well, he reacts quickly to both the run and the pass. He's aggressive in run support. He does not miss many tackles. He's a very consistent tackler, might be the most consistent tackler out of this year's safety crop. He'll line up and play man coverage on inside receivers. He's a good zone player. He fits very well with the Colts. He's a solid but not great athlete, but plays faster than his 40 time. Like I say, he's got a very high IQ. He's got great awareness and anticipation. Excellent special teams potential, and that's a thing we'll see with all these guys that we drafted on the second and third days, that a lot of these guys are going to be special teams guys at the beginning. But I think this kid could definitely, you know, contribute this year. He's got a solid frame, very, very physical kid with good balance to quickness. Like I said, he's a very reliable tackler, and he's rarely out of position, which kind of reminds me of Mathias Farley in that way. He's very savvy. He's not out of position. He makes all the plays. He's just a really, really high IQ football player and somebody that I think is definitely going to make our secondary better. And if we have any issues with injuries, we've got this guy, and I think he'd be fine back there. Some of the drawbacks to this guy, and there's not many. This kid is a pretty well-rounded player. The things that I saw, he doesn't have elite speed. He's not a speed guy. But again, he does play faster than his listed time, which was 4.6, I think. But he's not like, he doesn't run 4.3. He's not Earl Thomas back there. He struggles versus inside speed guys, and he also struggles versus just speed in general. He's definitely got to take the right angles when he's playing back there, because he can get beat over the top with vertical routes. He's got an average range, so he's not, I don't think he's a guy you'd play at free safety very often. More of a strong safety, box safety type guy. He's short for the position, but honestly, I don't really think that matters. He's 5'11", 213. That's not too bad. There's really not a lot of drawbacks to this kid. And usually when you get into the further down in the draft you go, you find a lot of negatives. But with this kid, there's really not too many. He makes up for the lack of speed and all that with instincts, IQ, film study, just knowing where to be, high awareness players. So very solid pick. I'll be honest, I wasn't sure about it at first when I heard what we gave up, but then I went back, watched some more film on the kid, and read on him a little bit, and he's definitely somebody that I think down the road can be an impact player for the Colts. And I do think he will contribute next year to special teams. And if there's injuries, he can absolutely come in and play and do a good job, because he's a very smart kid. He'll pick up the defense, and that won't be a problem with him. He'll come right in. He'll learn the defense. He'll be able to go in there if need be. So solid pick. Another good pick by Ballard. Like this kid. Can't wait to see what he does next year.
And did he grow up a Colt fan? Because I heard something he was talking about, Tony Dungy growing up rooting for the Colts. Did he have a family member with the Colts, or did he just
grow up? He's got a family member in the Ring of Honor, which is Billy Brooks, who I watched growing up when they were really, really bad in the 80s. Some of our listeners who are my age will probably remember Billy Brooks when they didn't have anything. This is even pre-Dickerson. He was drafted in 86. Had a great rookie year. He was a really, really good possession receiver for the Colts, one of their better players for the first decade they were in Indianapolis. And I think that's his uncle or his cousin or something like that. So he's definitely got the bloodlines, and it's really cool to have that connection. It's funny because it made me go back and watch some Billy Brooks highlights, because I hadn't watched any in a while and forgot how good of a player he was.
And then Billy Brooks went up to Buffalo, where he was on that Bills roster, and Frank Reich was the backup quarterback to Jim Kelly. So you do have this like huge circle, And then you had this kid growing up rooting for the Colts, because he talked about the Tony Dungy days, and obviously Billy Brooks was gone by then, way before then.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of connections. It's a really cool story. This is the kind of kid you really root for because there's so many great qualities about him. I mean, obviously you root for all players, all Colt players especially, but this kid is just a special individual and a really high character guy, and I'm excited to see what he brings to the team.